The idea is that we looked to bring this rock. We wanted a little visibility. The department has been in the natural science building for 60 years plus, and it shows no visibility. The natural resources building has a wonderful polar bear. You go in there, wow, it gets your attention right off the bat. We thought, well, could we do something that would be equivalent, that would enhance our students' identification and make them think more about geology as well as for visitors and staff and faculty. So the idea was to try to look and find some suitable rocks. We felt that it should encompass a variety of factors. It should recognize a contribution of our graduates who have worked in the mining industry. It should recognize the cultural and economic history of the mining in Michigan. It should have a wow factor. It's our Upper Rock. And we wanted it to be really significant and recognize Northern Michigan's or Northern Peninsula's contribution to the state.
Well, another MSU alumni, Bill Stelzer, recommended that Warren contact me to locate something suitable that would be a wow factor. I took him to several places, the last of which was the Little Mountain Mine here in Ishpeming, and he found a rock that he thought would satisfy his needs as a rock on display in front of the NatSci building on the campus. The rock represents an example of the early targeted mining of iron ore on this range. The age of the iron formation is bracketed between 1.874 and 1.91 billion years. And it's not a direct measurement of the iron formation, but some of the associated rocks. So that's why we can't be more specific. There's a good history and a lot to be learned from that rock.
Iron ore was discovered in the Upper Peninsula of Michigan in 1844. Mining started in 1846 and continued through the 20th century. And the iron and steel that came from that ore played a tremendous role in the industrialization of Michigan, the industrialization of the United States, and had really great impact on the economics and culture of Michigan and the United States. And having it on campus allows us to communicate with our students and with the public the important connections between the geologic history of Michigan and its cultural, economic, and social history.
From the 1840s until present, there's been an unbroken story of iron mining on three different ranges in the Upper Peninsula. All of the ore mined in the Upper Peninsula it was shipped through the lower Great Lakes, and some of it went to the River Rouge plant, Henry Ford's plant, to make cars. So it's a very connected story. It's not just about mining in the Upper Peninsula, but it's connected with the rest of the state on where that ore went to for automobile manufacture, World War II, and the steel that was used to make arms and munitions and for the war effort in World War II. So the story is a long story, and it's very much of a Michigan story.
I was approached by Tom Wagner and to move this rock. Our company has been involved in the mining industry and the transportation industry throughout the state of Michigan, Wisconsin, and Minnesota. We've been in Nishpeming since the company started. Our families are in Nishpeming and Marquette, and we thought it would be a good thing to do for both the city of Nishpeming and Michigan State University. It was a difficult rock to get out. It exceeds 26 ton, and I had to get the biggest backhoe that we had available to get it out.
The city council voted unanimously to provide this specimen to Michigan State University to sit outside the Natural Sciences Building. I'm thrilled by that. It means a lot for the city because every student that walks through those doors is going to see the rock and the plaque on the rock that says it came from Nishpeming. So the city will receive a lot of free publicity, quite valuable publicity, and probably attract a lot of people to come to visit Nishpeming to find out more about where did that rock come from and what else is up there. And so I think it's a very valuable outcome for both the city of Nishpeming and for Michigan State University.
So it was an extraordinary process to get this rock from the Upper Peninsula down here to Michigan State University's campus. It involves getting the rock from where it is in an abandoned mine, dragging it through the woods to the place you get it onto a road, and then having a crane lift it onto a truck and bring it to campus. Once it's here, you had to close off roads on campus and use a gigantic crane to put it into a specially designed space that could deal with this level of load. It really takes a massive team to bring this whole thing together.
Well, I hope that that our students will use it as a kind of a photo op for, like they do with Sparty in their graduation caps and gowns. I think it'll inspire them looking at this rock. I hope that it inspires not only the students, but as the faculty walk in, as we have visitors, the staff, hopefully it'll be attractive. And so as you walk by, you'll say, wow, that rock is interesting.